Store openings have been a key part of your recent strategy. Does that continue to be the case at the same pace moving forward?
I would say that the two main drivers of our business are the store openings, which you mentioned, and the same store sales growth. So let me talk about both of them. We actually, with regards to the store sale, the amount of stores, we accelerated the growth this year, and we slightly revised upwards our store opening target to 730 stores this year. With regards to the same store sales, we delivered another strong quarter, and that's the 18th, and I repeat it, 18th consecutive quarter of double-digit same store sales growth. So I would say that both these factors are equally important, and we are, as the management team, focusing on both of them.
Competition is getting a lot more intense. Magnit has been very aggressive moving into the low-cost store operations. Are they beginning to eat away, do you think, at your opportunity?
Not really. First of all, what I would like to say here is that we operate in a different sub-segment of retail, and that's the variety value retail. Even though we benefit from similar underlying macroeconomic trends as the hard discounts like those that you mentioned, and that's a shift to affordable shopping, and as consumers are trying to save amid the current macroeconomic backdrop. But at the same time, we operate in a very different, we have a very different customer value proposition and business model. We focus mainly on non-food, and 3/4 of our assortment is classical non-food and drogery. We rotate this assortment very fast in order to provide our customers with the so-called treasure hunting appeal, such that they return to our stores more often. And in general, we have a kind of very different business model. So like in simple terms, we are more like Dollar General and Five Below of the world rather than Aldi and Lidl. So to your question, no, we don't see them. We're in a different subsegment.
Good morning, Anton. I want to ask you about like-for-like traffic. I noticed the increase of 9% this time round versus what you had in the previous results, where we saw a decline of almost 3%. What does this tell us about the normalizing COVID trends you're witnessing, and what type of traffic can we anticipate from here?
Last year, comparison base was quite uneven for obvious reasons, as we are well aware. So in the second quarter this year, the traffic got back to the positive territory on the back of normalization in the COVID easing of the COVID restrictions, and things slowly get back to normal. So as I mentioned in the beginning of my speech, we are currently prioritizing traffic by promoting food and essential non-food products, because it will help us to grow in the future, in the long term, and it lays solid foundation for our growth.